Coming up, we'll take a look at your options for connecting your on-premises data center and workloads to Azure. We start by looking at how you can establish connectivity with Azure Virtual Network to connect your general workloads, including the protection of your resources with Azure Firewall. We'll then take things to the next level with a look at establishing your own resilient and secure private connection to Azure from your main sites with ExpressRoute, including new options with ExpressRoute Direct at 100 gigabits, which provides you fast transfer speeds from your data center to the cloud, ExpressRoute Global Reach, which allows you to leverage Microsoft's global network to connect your sites together, and we'll show you how you can connect thousands of branch offices by automating the configuration and connectivity of your branch sites at scale with the Azure Virtual WAN service. The first step to any hybrid configuration between your data center and Azure is setting up network connections. The Azure Virtual Network, or VNet, is your network in the cloud, connecting all your cloud resources within a region or between regions. It can also become a bridge for hybrid connectivity to connect your on-premises resources. So let's start with how you can create a virtual network in Azure. So here I am, going to search for VNet. Then within Virtual Network, I'll go ahead and create one. I'll give it a name, address space, assign a resource group, choose a location. The subnet here needs to work with the address space we just entered, along with options for DDoS protection, service endpoints, and firewall. Next, you need to set up a virtual network gateway. Just search for gateway and add one. Now, this can be over the public internet, or you can have a dedicated connection via ExpressRoute. We leave the default standard. Select the VNet we just created. Create a new IP address. And create. Once I have a basic network configured along with my gateway, I can then set up bi-directional communication using a few connection options. To do that, I'll search for connections, create a connection. I have a few options, VNet to VNet, site to site, or ExpressRoute. Then I'll go ahead and select a resource group here. I'll leave the other defaults and click OK. Next, I'll choose my virtual network gateway. I'll select an appropriate ExpressRoute circuit that I created in advance. Give it a connection name. Now, once I create this connection, I'll have secure bi-directional communication with my network. Now, let's get back to the VNet we created earlier. We'll create a network level firewall for the virtual network we just created. This will protect all of my Azure resources, like my virtual machines and even VM scale sets, against unwanted inbound or outbound connections in this network. So let me show you how to set up a firewall. I'll click on the VNet. I'll select firewall, create a firewall, add a new one. Here I need to select a resource group, give it a name, select the VNet I built. That'll pull in the address space, then I'll create one. That's going to take a moment to provision. When it's complete, within rules, I can block or allow connections. I'll block the TCP protocol over port 443 and click on Add. Now, this is a stateful firewall as a service with built-in high availability and unrestricted cloud scale. As a network admin, I can centrally manage network connectivity using policies across subscriptions and virtual networks. In addition to the built-in Azure firewall, you can also use other network virtual appliances available in the Azure Marketplace. Now, as I was setting up my virtual network gateway and connections, I showed you where the options were to use an ExpressRoute connection. If you're new to ExpressRoute, it lets you extend your on-premises networks into the Microsoft cloud over a private connection facilitated by a connectivity provider. You can use ExpressRoute to connect to Microsoft cloud services, and it's a great option for a dedicated low latency connection between your existing WAN and Microsoft. We have a number of options for connectivity. You can connect via your telco or ISP, your data center provider, or with the new ExpressRoute Direct, you can have your own direct port inside the Microsoft network, allowing up to 100 gigabits per second bandwidth. ExpressRoute Direct is available in select locations. Now, you'll remember earlier that I configured ExpressRoute for my virtual gateway and connection. Here, we are going to use the direct option. With ExpressRoute Direct, your connection is consistently fast, and to show what a direct connection can do, here, I have spun up 12 VMs, and I'm performing 450 gigabytes of data ingestion into Azure. I'm letting the transfer happen in real time, and you'll see once it starts, the throughput ranges between 6 and 9 gigabits per second per VM. Where this gets even better is if you are a multi-site environment with offices located across regions or continents, you can join them together using ExpressRoute Global Reach. This allows you to link your ExpressRoute circuits together to make a private network between your on-premises sites. This is particularly useful if you need to use different providers. For example, you may have linked all your main sites in the US, but your service provider or telco doesn't operate in a few countries within Asia. With ExpressRoute Global Reach, you can work with an alternative ExpressRoute provider, and Microsoft will connect your branches there to the ones in the US using our global network, which spans 54 regions, more than 100,000 miles of fiber, and over 135 edge sites. Let's show this in action. We'll start off in the Azure portal, and I've already created a virtual network with all the connections I need. Here, I have two servers in two different locations, and they are connected to their local networks. I'm going to try and have each server ping the other server. We'll start with the left server pinging the server on the right, and then right pinging the server on the left. To get these two servers to talk to one another, we'll enable our global reach connectivity, and we'll do that via partial. I'll create the peering connection, get the relevant circuits, add our global reach connection, then initialize our ExpressRoute connection, and now I'll run the script. And you'll see that servers can talk to each other. So in just a few seconds, I have connected one remote data center with my other remote data center. One last thing I want to show you is how you can also automate connections from your smaller branch sites to the Azure Global Network. This allows you to attach, in some cases, thousands of branch offices to the cloud without requiring advanced skills to configure the connection at the branch site. Think of Azure Virtual WAN as a hub capable of connecting VNets and branch sites, or even mobile users using the internet, using VPN, or via a private connection with ExpressRoute. And you can monitor them all from the Azure portal. Let's go ahead and create a Virtual WAN resource. Let's give it a name. Let's pick a resource group. In my case, I'll create a new one. Then let's click Refresh. And there it is. So now you have a Virtual WAN. Next, I'm going to walk you through a software solution with NetFoundry SD-WAN, but you can use your favorite VPN device solution, and you can check out our list of Virtual WAN partners at the link shown. First, we'll register the NetFoundry controller as an app. We'll click this resource group's access control. Then we'll add a role for the NetFoundry controller. Let's pick the contributor access here. Let's locate the NetFoundry app ID and provide it the permission to access Azure Virtual WAN. So now let's get into the NetFoundry management dashboard. I'm clicking into my subscription. We'll plug in all the details of the app we just created. That includes our subscription ID, app ID, tenant ID, and key. Then we locate our Azure Virtual WAN. This enables a NetFoundry controller to write into Azure. Next, you can select all your branches and push that information into Azure. So now I'm back in Azure. When I hit refresh, you will see our branches are flowing in. From here, we'll need to create a hub. Let's put in the location. Let's put in a private address space. This should not overlap with your on-premises address space. Now select all your branches and associate them with the hub we just created. In my case, I select the first branch, select the hub, and click confirm. This fires off a backend process where the VPN gateways are created and a configuration file is generated. The NetFoundry controller periodically polls and downloads this configuration and applies it to the branch sites, as a result of which the branches, they come up connected. Now, you may have resources in Azure that you want to connect to. So let's go ahead and attach that resource VNet to the hub. Click on Virtual Network Connection, add a connection, give it a name, pick your hub, pick the VNet that you want to connect to your hub, then click OK. So let's wrap it up. In your overview blade here, as you can see, we see all our hubs, including the West US branch that we just connected. So that was an overview of networking options in Azure and recent updates to our ExpressRoute services. You can get started by setting up an Azure trial to configure a hybrid network and firewall. ExpressRoute Direct and ExpressRoute Global Reach are available today. You can learn more at the link shown. And finally, if you're exploring setting up internet-based connectivity, try Azure Virtual WAN. And you can check to see supported partner appliance devices at the link shown. Thanks for watching.